if you are a real estate investor or you want to be a real estate investor and you're wanting more funding for your deals, you're in the right place. I'm going to plug you into the money in just a moment. I'm Jay Conner, the Private Money Authority, and we're having my live event right here in Atlantic Beach, North Carolina, with a group of real estate investors from all across the nation. And folks, if this has been an amazing event to you, put your hands together and let me know. I promised you when I started a moment ago that I was going to plug you into the funding. So where can you learn about private money and what it's all about? Go to www.jayconner.com/moneywebinar, all in lowercase. So that's www.jayconner.com/ all in lowercase, money webinar. On that webinar, I will reveal to you how I raised $2,150,000 in less than 90 days when I was cut off from the banks with no notice. You'll also learn the 5 easy steps on getting private money from people you know, and you will also learn the 5 easy steps on getting private money from existing private lenders. So with that, of course, we've got some questions here in the audience. We got questions that have already been submitted ahead of time.
Got a new one.
And we have a new question right here. So I'm going to answer these first that were sent in, and then we'll take questions online, Kent, and we'll have them right here in the room. All right? So first of all, first question is, do I need to register my investment company with a state or federal 64 investing? And the answer is no. The actual entity that I use on buying or investing in real estate is a simple LLC. I have one LLC for the real estate houses that are flipping, and I also have a different LLC for buy and holds. Another question is already sent in ahead of time from Daryl. Says, what or how do I get funding to flip my homes? Good question, Daryl. Go to that webinar or that online class, on-demand class, and that'll get you started. Again, at the jayconner.com/moneywebinar. And then Lance wrote in, what is a good investment strategy for foreclosures? Wow. Kent, do we remember my website for foreclosures? I believe we do. I've got another online class, on-demand class, it's free, that you can go to about foreclosures. And so that is www.jayconner.com/ all in lowercase, foreclosure webinar. Foreclosure webinar. What you'll learn on that webinar is about my foreclosure system, to where we have an 8-letter direct mail campaign that gets a crazy 57% response, and how we also track every foreclosure in whatever market it is that you want to be investing in. All right, so I'm going to have another question just handed in, and that is, I'm a first-time rehabber with a potential buyer who wants upgrades on the finishes of the house. My rehab budget doesn't have room for upgrades. How do I keep my buyer engaged and happy without losing all of my profits? Did this come from here in the room by chance, or is this, or was it sent in? From over here? Okay, so let's run the mic over here, Milo. And it's Mary, right? Okay, so everybody, we've got Mary here. And where are you from, Mary? I forgot your city and state.
I am from Aiden, North Carolina.
From Aiden, that's right, the Greenville area, North Carolina. Yeah, so rephrase your question for me.
I am a first-time rehabber, I was over at my property. Someone drove up and said, hey, did you buy this house? And I go, I did. And they go, well, we sure would like it. And I said, well, it's going to be for sale once I get a rehab. But they're already starting to say, oh, we want laminate throughout. Uh-huh. I have budgeted the carpet. We want tile in the bathrooms. I have budgeted the linoleum. Mm-hmm. And it's, so how do I keep them engaged, happy, and let them have their options, their choices, without totally losing
sure. So
my budget?
What's the anticipated profit you have on the deal right now?
My profit will be in the 25,000 range.
25,000. With what they're saying, how many square feet is the house?
It is 1,590.
Okay, so average size house around here for Eastern North Carolina.
3-2.
Yeah, 3-bed, 2-bath. So if you're looking at making 25,000, and with what you said, the difference is going to be only about $2,000 to $3,000 from what I just heard you say that they were wanting, right? So if you got a hot buyer right now, I'd be happy to pay $22,000 instead of $25,000. Yeah, I mean, work with them. Work with them. Don't stay necessary to your own budget if you can go ahead and make $22,000 right now. In fact, Mary is one of our new Platinum and Mastermind members, so congratulations, Mary. Let's give Mary a hand for coming on. One more time, folks. Let's give everybody. Oh, here's Carol Jolie. Y'all, this is my wife, Carol Jolie.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining us. We've had a great week. We want you to come visit us at the Crystal Coast and enjoy a week like these folks have just enjoyed.
Yep, we're doing this event here in Eastern North Carolina at least 4 times a year now. And so we'd love to have you come to the event in the near future. So everybody here that's live, let's give everybody that tuned in online a hand for joining. Bye for now.